The legislative session wrapped up this week, and as always, some bills made it through and others didn't make the cut. This past year, homelessness has been at the forefront for city and state government. Alexander Zanes is digging deeper tonight into what the state did this session to tackle that issue. Alexander?
Kathy, homelessness continues to be one of the biggest issues facing the state. In this legislative session, lawmakers passed multiple pieces of legislation that they say will translate to the homeless population getting off the streets and into housing.
This legislative session, lawmakers approved $12 million in funding to combat homelessness in Hawaii. The funds will go towards a variety of state programs, including homeless outreach services, the state's Housing First program, and rent subsidies, among others. So how will the bulk of the money be spent? Well, that's still to be determined.
What we're hoping is, because of the flexibility, we're hoping that it will give the governor's office, it will give DHS that flexibility to expend money right away instead of saying, okay, it's stuck here in rapid rehousing, we don't know what to do.
Because the funds are not outlined in line items in the budget, the onus will be on state homeless service providers to spend the money where it's needed, including the neighbor islands.
I'm really pleased that it came out as a lump sum, because I believe our neighbor islands definitely have homelessness issues. And a lot of times they're not seen. You might see them in Honolulu, maybe underneath a highway or sleeping on a sidewalk. But when you're in the neighbor islands, they can be out off the grid and they're in poverty and they're really in trouble.
The legislature also passed a bill that would fund mental health services, something lawmakers feel is at the heart of the homelessness issue.
We did provide $500,000 to really start to address mental health needs with those that are chronically homeless, and how are we making sure that we provide services, programs for them, because we realize that in many cases, this is what's keeping them homeless.
Along with combating mental health issues facing the homeless population, the state is working to subsidize affordable housing, not just to buy, but to rent as well. HB 1700 provides over $91 million to subsidize affordable rental housing.
If we don't get inventory in, even an older unit gets very expensive because there's just no units available. Having units available is the key to bringing affordability, and there's only one way to do that: build more units, and build more units with the affordable restrictions.
And I'll keep following up and let you know what we find out about how specifically the funds will be spent. Alexander Zanes, KHON 2 News.